team champion, Cowboy Bob Kelly. Kelly. His opponent on my right in the white wrestling tights from New York City, New York, weighing 238 pounds, the internationally famous Intern. Intern. This match, 2 out of 3 falls, will have a 30-minute time limit. Paul Morton is our referee, and he reminds the wrestlers of the rules and regulations of the Mississippi State Athletic Commission. Remember now, in all the towns that I was talking about a little bit earlier, the match will start at 8:15. The doors open at 7 o'clock. And that's on Monday at the Civic Center in Laurel, Tuesday, Pascagoula Sports Center, in Pascagoula, corner Market Street and Ingalls Avenue. And by the way, you get your advance sale ticket for Pascagoula from Marie Dickens at Market Street Car Wash, 110 Market Street. Wednesday, the old Pineville Gym in Pineville, Mississippi. Thursday, the Wade Kennedy Livestock Show Arena in Hattiesburg. On Friday, outdoors at the Mississippi-Alabama Fairgrounds in Meridian. And on Saturday, Gulf Coast Sports Center. On 30th Avenue, Gulf Coast Sports Center, 30th Avenue in Gulfport. We'll look forward to seeing you at the matches. Doors open at 7. First match starts at 8:15. Cowboy Bob Kelly and the Intern. Another takedown by Cowboy Bob Kelly on the Intern. A count of 1 on the Intern. Referee checking. Make sure that the Intern's shoulders are not on the mat. Cowboy Bob Kelly with the advantage now on the Intern. The Intern pulled hair. Referee Paul Morton warns the Intern about pulling hair. Count of 1 on Cowboy Bob Kelly. Good to be back home at Channel 7. Back home. This is where I started doing the wrestling on television about 13 or 14 years ago. Some of you may remember when we did the programs live on Saturday night from Channel 7. It's been a good while ago. A lot of water under the bridge since then. Always great bunch of guys to work with here at Channel 7 in Hattiesburg. And we're happy to be back here taping our programs. Anytime you're in Hattiesburg on Friday mornings at 9 o'clock, that's when we do the taping for television, and you're invited to the television at the studios at WBAM-TV, Channel 7 in Hattiesburg. Any Friday morning at 9 o'clock, be here, of course, around 8:30, and we'd be happy to have you at the television matches. Count of 1 on Cowboy Bob Kelly. Overhead wrist lock. Each wrestler pitting strength against strength, power against power, and the Intern used hair. Kelly goes into a hammerlock, and the Intern switches it into an overhead wrist lock, and now Kelly with the advantage in the wrist lock. By Kelly. Referee Paul Morton warns Cowboy Bob Kelly. Fans at ringside tell the referee that the Intern used hair. Strength against strength. The Intern against Cowboy Bob Kelly. Kelly with the advantage, and the Intern pulled hair. Hammerlock on the Intern by Cowboy Bob Kelly. Remember now, there will be several City Tag Team Championship matches this week. So far, no one team is even close to having the five Tag Team Championship jackets from the five cities in Mississippi. And remember, the team that gets all five jackets will receive a $1,000 bonus and will get a trophy. A lot of interest in this, and a lot of the wrestlers are very interested in receiving the $1,000 bonus. A couple of knee drops on the intern's arm. A series of knee drops by Cowboy Bob Kelly on the intern, and the intern is forced to submit. The intern is forced to submit Cowboy Bob Kelly, the winner of the first fall in this 2-out-of-3-fall match. The intern submits to a series of knee drops at the hands of Cowboy. Won the first ball. Cowboy Bob Kelly applying pressure on a hammerlock on the intern. Paul Morton, the third man in the ring. They're in the ropes. Referee Paul Morton calls for the break. And the intern pulls Kelly to the mat and is warned by the referee to break clean. Overhead wrist lock. On the rope, the referee counting, warns the intern about a clean break on the ropes. Two wrestlers in a boxing stance. Deal across the ring by Kelly on the intern. Another deal. And the intern goes for the ropes. And the referee warns the intern, get in the ring and wrestle. Headlock on Kelly by the intern. Takedown by the intern. The intern applying a headlock on Cowboy Bob Kelly. Referee check. Kelly now with an overhead wrist lock, and the intern used Kelly's tights. A takedown by Cowboy Bob Kelly on the intern and an arm bar. The intern complains to referee Paul Morton that Cowboy Bob Kelly was using his mask to pull him to the mat. Remember now, we are in color. The past couple of weeks on wrestling, we've been in black and white, but we are in color this time. Beautiful color, too. Cowboy Bob Kelly, an arm twist, high pressure. The intern goes down and into an arm bar. Cowboy Bob Kelly with the advantage on the intern. Remember now, we're always happy to hear from you. Your cards and letters are always gratefully received. Just address them now to Clem Courtney in care of wrestling, WDAM-TV, Hattiesburg, Mississippi. Or you can send them to the station that you're watching. Clem Courtney, care of wrestling, care of the station that you're watching, Channel 13. Channel 7 or Channel 24, Channel 13 in Gulfport, Biloxi, Pascagoula,
Channel 7 in Hattiesburg or Channel 24 in Meridian. We'll get it a little bit quicker, get it on the air maybe for you, as much time as we have to get them on the air. We'll send it to Clem Courtney, WDAM-TV, Hattiesburg, Mississippi. The intern, using the hair, throws Cowboy Bob Kelly into the turnbuckle. Low to the face. Low to the jaw of Cowboy Bob Kelly by the intern. Into the turnbuckles. Cowboy Bob Kelly moves out of the way. A brain crusher on the intern. Intern into the turnbuckles. Low to the midsection. Arm twist. An arm bar, a takedown by Kelly. Count of one on the intern. The intern, using tights, pulls Kelly into the ropes, and the referee calls for the break. Low to the midsection of Cowboy Kelly by the intern. Headlock. Now, Cowboy Bob Kelly into the ropes and tackle. Another knee right to the midsection of Cowboy Bob Kelly.
Down a three on Kelly, and the winner of our second fall, the intern over Cowboy Bob Kelly. So now, everything's all split up, one fall apiece. So we'll have the third and deciding fall in this exciting match in just a moment after this. Important word.
And we have with us Bobby Whitlock and Cowboy Bob Kelly. We're going to talk about the big wrestling card this coming Friday night at the Mississippi-Alabama Fairgrounds in Meridian. Now, there will be a City of Meridian Tag Team Championship match on the card, and this will be the first match in Meridian that Bobby Fields has created for you folks here as the new matchmaker. And he wants definitely a City of Meridian Tag Team Champion. So he's put Whitlock and Kelly together just to see what they can do against the Big Blue Yankee and Gentleman Jim. We'll talk about that match. Also on the card this week, Salento Rodriguez, who's very popular in Meridian, takes on Dandy Jack Morrell, a newcomer to this area. The opening match will have Billy Hamilton meeting Ali Alibi. So it's a great wrestling card. Friday night at the Mississippi-Alabama Fairgrounds. The gates open at 7 o'clock. The first match starts at 8:15. Kelly, the match that you were in for the City of Meridian Tag Team Championship last night was stopped, and both teams were disqualified. So you have another chance this week.
Clem, let me put it like this. The Blue Yankee and I have had these jackets now for, I guess, 6-8 weeks. And ever since we've had them, it looks like it's been in an uproar. And he won't give in, and I'm not about to give in. So, like you say, Bobby has got this job as matchmaker, and he's put me and Bobby Whitlock together as a team. To try to settle this thing once and for all. And, of course, the Blue Yankee has Gentleman Jim. Now, I want to personally thank the Blue Yankee for me having Bobby Whitlock as a partner.
What do you mean by that?
Well, I helped Bobby Whitlock get a match with the Blue Yankee for the Mississippi State Championship.
Right.
Bobby Whitlock won the championship without my help. He beat the Blue Yankee and won the belt. The Blue Yankee insisted that I get Bobby Whitlock as a partner to go against him and Gentleman Jim against the jackets that me and the Blue Yankee also held in Hattiesburg. Mm-hmm. Now then, last Thursday night in Hattiesburg, Bobby Whitlock and myself went in the ring and beat the Blue Yankee and Gentleman Jim, and we are now the City of Hattiesburg Tag Team Champions. So since we make such a good team, and I'm thanking the Blue Yankee again for this, because before Bobby Whitlock and I was a first thing from our minds is being tag team partners in this part of the territory. Mm-hmm. So we are going to be tag team partners from now on, and we're going to get these Meridian jackets next week, and we're going to get every jacket that's in any of these towns around here, and we're going to get the $1,000 and the trophy.
All right. Well, good luck to you, and good luck to you, Whitlock.
Thank you, Clem.
We're about out of time, but remember, it is a great wrestling card in Meridian this coming Friday night at the Mississippi-Alabama Fairgrounds. The gates open at 7. The first match starts at 8:15, and we'll see you there.
Out of the ring. Referee's counting. The intern has to the count of 20 to get back into the ring. And Cowboy Bob Kelly will manage Bobby Whitlock. He got the Blue Yankee to sign the contract. And you heard me ask Yankee, did he read it? And he didn't. And so the Yankee was tricked again by Cowboy Bob Kelly signing a contract. And Kelly will manage Bobby Whitlock in the championship match. Overhead wristlock on the intern by Cowboy Bob Kelly. A takedown by Kelly. Count of one on the intern. Referee Paul Morton asked the intern if he will submit. And the referee warns the intern about using Cowboy Bob Kelly's tights to advantage. They're in the ropes. The referee calls for the break, a takedown. And the intern did not break clean, so Paul Morton tells the intern that he must break clean. He breaks up the hold that the intern had on Kelly. On the head of Cowboy Bob Kelly by the intern, and Kelly retaliates. Kelly thrown out on this concrete floor. He has to the count of 20 to get back in the ring. Kelly tries to come back in. The intern grabs him on the ropes. Him, drops him. The intern crawls on Cowboy Bob Kelly, and the referee has signaled the timekeeper to ring the bell. The intern disqualified for pulling Kelly into the ring, and referee Paul Morton awards the match to the Kelly, disqualifying the intern. So the winner of our second match is Cowboy Bob Kelly over the intern.
Is it they find me? They find $50.
They find Kelly $50.
Well, I don't care if they should find $1,000, but I want them to know one thing. I still got the belt.
You didn't get any pay.
I whipped Kelly's head. I beat his brains in. He bled, but I ain't satisfied because they're not going to take my $50. And they're not going to take this belt. I'll take Kelly and I'll beat him any day, any time, as long as he keeps his so-called friends off of me. This guy's yellow. He stinks. He's rotten. I'm the man that does it. I'm the champion right here. And I'm going to tell you right here.
Just a minute. Here's Cowboy Bob Kelly.
You don't push me right
there. There they are. That's Fargo. There's Fargo and Kelly. Hey, you all can't do this. The match had to be stopped last night. Kelly was fined $50. Fargo was fined $50. Their pay was held up, and they're still going at it. Fargo's bleeding in the head. Here's Rip Tyler pulling the wrestlers, the only ones that can separate them. Hippies come in, pull them apart. I don't know what we're going to do with this one. Getting kind of ridiculous. You can't even have an interview or anything.
He's not supposed to have that belt on.
That belt was
held up.
I know the belt was held up.
All right, what's he doing wearing?
Well, I don't have
any. Where's Speedy at, huh?
Speedy's Petey is out of town in Oklahoma. He had a death in the family. He isn't here, but he'll be back, and we'll see what can be.
Well, I'll be back, too.
Gracious. Cowboy Bob Kelly. Frank Dalton. Gracious. It's Kelly and Fargo at it again. My God. Look, hey, Kelly. Kelly, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Just a minute now. Just a minute. Come on. Come on now. No, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Come on now, Kelly. Come on. Come on now.
Back up in your corner.
All right, this is our main event match for television. Two out of three falls with the time remaining on the television program. Introducing on my left in the blue Levi's from Louisville, Kentucky, weighing 216 pounds, Cowboy Bob Kelly. Kelly. His opponent on my right in the black wrestling tights from St. Louis, Missouri, weighing 252 pounds, one half of the United States Tag Team Champions, and this is Rip Tyler. Tyler. His partner, the other half of the United States Tag Team Champions, Eddie Sullivan. Now, I want to remind you of Beaumont, Mississippi on Wednesday night, March 1st. A great wrestling card in Beaumont, Mississippi, this coming Wednesday night, March 1st. And we've got some top-notch wrestlers appearing on that card Wednesday night in Beaumont. And there you go. Rip Tyler. Cowboy Bob Kelly. Remember, Beaumont, Mississippi, Wednesday night, March 1st. This coming Wednesday night, a great wrestling card in Beaumont. Remember, Pascagoula on Wednesday night for this 1 week only, and then also on Wednesday night, March 1st, Beaumont, Mississippi. That'll be at the school in Beaumont. That's at the elementary school in Beaumont on Wednesday night. Great wrestling card Wednesday night in Beaumont. An arm drag, hip toss, flying mare, sort of a hip toss that was. Cowboy Bob Kelly in command of the situation. Third man in the ring, Buddy Carson, the referee. Hammerlock being applied on Kelly by Rip Tyler. One half of the United States Tag Team Champions. Rip Tyler along with Eddie Sullivan. An arm scissors being applied on Cowboy Bob Kelly by Rip Tyler. Try for the pin. Count of one. And Tyler. Use the hair to pull Kelly down. The referee makes him break. Drop. Across the upper part of Kelly's arm. Arm twist. Drop across Kelly's arm. Stomp. Stomp. Kelly goes out of the ring. Wrestling every Friday night in Meridian. A wrestling arena on the Mississippi-Alabama fairgrounds in Meridian. That's Friday nights. We have a great wrestling card lined up this Friday night in Meridian. Overhead wrist lock. All right, Kelly started with those fists. He's had about enough. And here comes Donnie Fargo. And the professional is trying to keep Fargo out of the ring. Kelly hitting and stomping Fargo now. Professional trying to guard Fargo. Professional. The professional on Fargo. Hammerlock with the knee drop across the upper part of the arm of Rip Tyler. And the doors have to be guarded. Here comes Fargo again. Even with the guards on the door, Fargo rushes through to get Kelly. Here comes Dalton to try to separate Kelly from Fargo, the professional. Kelly warning Fargo, telling the referee to go get Fargo and tell him to come on out here. He's just... Well, Kelly's leaving the ring.
How am I supposed to have a match?
Huh? Well, they've got guards trying to watch the room out here. Not saw anything like. Well, Kelly not wanting to go in the ring. Now Kelly just goes back to the dressing room. All right. Well, here comes Kelly and Fargo now. Great day in the morning. Well, this match between Kelly and Rip Tyler just stopped. Nobody can separate Fargo and Kelly. That's why I say Thursday night in Hattiesburg. Kelly bleeding. All right, the referee,
Buddy Carson has just informed me that a $25 fine has been placed on Donnie Fargo and Cowboy Bob Kelly. So that's $75 now. They were both fined $50 for last Thursday night. Fined $25 for their shenanigans here on television. Now, boy, Bob Kelly, you can see where he's bleeding. Buddy Carson said Kelly and Fargo both fined $25 for the television shenanigans. And so they were fined $50 Thursday night, so that's $75.
Texas, a combined weight of 508 pounds. Here are Dutch and Ron Bass, the Bass Brothers. In their corner will be their father, Maw Bass. My right, ladies and gentlemen, from Canada, weighing 254 pounds, here is Rip Tyler. Rip Tyler. And from Louisville, Kentucky, at 219 pounds, Cowboy Bob Kelly. Cowboy Bob Kelly. Submission match only. Submission bout. Thank you. One bout to follow for the Gulf Coast Championship. Big tag team match here in downtown Mobile at the Expo Hall, and this ought to be a thriller. Here's what you have. In the Bass's corner, you have Big Red, appointed as a special downstairs referee by the Alabama Boxing and Wrestling Commission. Bob Bass is also in that corner. Jimmy McGuire is the referee, and this is a submission bout. In other words, the falls, the referee in the ring, will not even make a count, because falls do not count. A man must submit for his team to lose. Rip Tyler in there now against Big Ron Bass, and he's using those body drops. Boy, and he's hooking that foot right on that left arm of Ron Bass, and those knee drops coming up right now. The knee drops. Twist of the arm. Rip Tyler. Tyler to the advantage now. Ron Bass went to school at West Texas State, the big one in the ring now. And his brother Dutch Bass went to the University of Houston. There's Cowboy Bob Kelly in the ring now. Referee disallows tag because the man was not in the corner. He was on the ring apron moving. That's also a rope match. Forgot to mention that, but a man must hold on to that rope that you see them doing now. This is a combination of most everything. Entirely different than what you've seen, a rope match, a submission match. One referee in, one referee out. But it's 60 minutes. So we'll see what happens in that time period. Hammerlock now that Rip Tyler has on Big Ron Bass. And Dutch was about to give a kick. But he's still holding on to the rope, but he illegally coming into the ring. And that's what Cowboy Bob Kelly is complaining about to the referee. That bend back right there on the arm. And Ron Bass, that's a hurt hold. Tyler asks the referee to ask him about a submission. He's got his left foot, Tyler has, planted on the left arm of Ron Bass, and that's where he's getting his leverage. You see that in that hammerlock position? But he has an arm lock on the other arm, so he has the definite advantage over Ron Bass, and Rip Tyler can really put on the pressure. There's Paul Bass complaining to the referee, and the Big Red goes over and tells Paul Bass to sit down. Hold is maintained by Tyler now. Maintains the hold, but Ron Bass has his right foot on the bottom strand of the rope. So the tag goes to Cowboy Bob, who comes in the ring to take up where Tyler left off. Ooh, he smashes off that shoulder now. They're working on that left arm. They really are. Giving it all they can. Down pull by Ron Bass right above us. That arm twist. And Dutch Bass comes into the ring, and the same hold is applied by Kelly. Now he's tagging off to Tyler, and Tyler's coming in. Drives a right to the face, using a leg trip beautifully by Tyler. And, well, they're working on the left arm of both Dutch and Ron. Some hair pulling going on there by Dutch. Caught by the referee. Nice somersault out of it. But Tyler has the advantage now in this tag team match. Another leg trip, beautifully done. And Tyler working at maximum force in this bout. Of course, they face two toughies. And Kelly, oh, he gets an eye gouge that time. Ducks away. Oh! Dutch backing away from Cowboy Bob. See who Big Red is rooting for. Now it's the arm of Kelly, and he swings out of it. Loops out of it nicely. Tag is made legally. And Ron Bass in there. Staying away from Kelly. Lucas tonight and Eddie Sullivan vie for the Gulf Coast Wrestling Championship. Sullivan holds the belt. They vie for it in the big main event here at the Expo Hall. This match is one fall 60, but we may not have time to complete this one. Due to the fact we have TV allotted time and cannot go beyond that. Ooh, look at that. Boy, did Tyler take one that time. Boy, he came, it looked like he came from the top of the lights, and another one. in the back by Dutch. Again, Tyler was hurt on that drop. Looked like he came down from the lights. And then was whipped into the corner by Bass. Just heard Ron Bass said, bring him over here. Look at that knee jammed into the face of Rip Tyler. Now they're working on Tyler's left arm. And he's away from Kelly, so he can't get to him. And he'd like right at this point to make a tag, get away. Well, this may be the round over. Nope. See, Tyler's shoulder's not down. Boy, he's got Tyler pretty well set there. Well, I don't know what Jimmy McGuire called then on the break, but he did. Dutch Bass with the advantage over Rip Tyler now. Kelly trying to reach him. He can't tag if his other hand is holding the rope. Well, this bout has various rules. Nope, he didn't get to tag him. Did not get to tag him. Tyler did not get to tag Cowboy Bob Kelly, and now he's at the mercy of Dutch and Ron Bass, the Bass Boys. And Bob Bass seems to be pretty well satisfied with how things are going right now, and well, he should be, because he's got 2-on-1, and now Ron Bass is using the rope to choke Tyler off in the corner. Farthest from you as you're watching. Boy, they're shooting right hands now. Tyler going to his knees. Well, we hope we can bring you all of this bout, because it promises to be a hectic one, as you can see by what's going on inside the squared circle. But as we said before, we have TV a lot of time, and we may have to leave you. Kelly still has a hold of that rope. Now, if he makes the tag, then it's all right. Dutch won't let Tyler get to Kelly. Now, there's a legal tag right there. As Dutch Bass. Into the corner they go. Now watch the ropes. Dutch Bass using those ropes. I don't know if Big Red sees it or not. And Dutch kicks Big Red. Big Red was trying to break. They do have that rope. And that's a noose, but Tyler gets away. Bass leaping into the corner. But Tyler was able to get away from him. Shot to the midsection, another one. And now Tyler gets between the legs of Dutch Bass. That sling, remember now, balls don't count at all. We were counting in the last. There's the bulldog by Cowboy Bob Kelly, the old bulldog hold that he uses so well. And Paw Bass is pulled down by Big Red, another bulldog. That clutch that Cowboy Bob Kelly is using. Submission match. Look at Big Red over there. He has Paw Bass right against the ring apron. And Dutch had had enough, apparently, with those bulldog holds. Dutch Bass had had enough. Well, the referee could continue. So, well, that's it for now, and we'll be back with more wrestling action in just a little while. We've had some trouble with the Stanley boys. They wouldn't get in the ring for the longest time, and their manager, Paw Bass, they're finally in the ring. And Frank Stanley, well, he's in the opposite corner. That's Gene Stanley. Now, he is not wrestling. It's Frank Stanley, the other one. But they have had all kind of controversy about who's where and where is what and so on. So our television time is just about run out now. It took so long to get into the ring that there isn't much else we can do. And they're still not ready to wrestle. Well, I don't know what you do in a case like this, but the fans are saying, get in there and get to wrestle. And Cowboy Bob Kelly is calling for a disqualification.
We're taking it, go ahead and narrow it.
Yeah. Cowboy Bob Kelly with an arm sling now on Frank Kelly in a big match. Real big one. Bob Ass and also brother Gene Stanley are in Frank's corner. He's 250 pounds from Hollywood, Florida. And an arm sling by Cowboy Bob Kelly now. And Frank wants a little bit of time. We've had some extraordinary matches on every card held here in downtown Mobile. Another arm sling by Cowboy Bob Kelly. Frank Stanley circling around Kelly now. Trying to get to him. Forearm smash. And Kelly delivers one in return right to the button. They have had something going. And how this match is developing now. Back goes Frank. Lift by Cowboy Bob Kelly on Frank Stanley. In the opposite corner, Gene Stanley and Pa Bass. Frank going over to get some support from his brother. Circling around, trying to get in position. Kelly stalking Stanley. Side headlock by Kelly. Rings it now. And a shoulder sling. Kelly to the advantage in this match right now. This point in time, we might say, because it could, well, it didn't. And Gene comes into the ring. He's not even a second. I don't know what he's doing in there. It's going to be two against one. And Kelly working on both of them. And he rips Frank into the corner and Gene right into him. Kelly has two men. There's the bulldog by Cowboy Bob Kelly. Oh, he laid it to Gene and wins it. Cowboy Bob Kelly, the winner. Cowboy Bob Kelly. Amazing display. He had to wrestle both brothers. and pinned actually Gene Stanley. But nevertheless, Stanley was in there when he shouldn't be. So the victory goes to Cowboy Bob Kelly. And there's Maw Bass standing in the corner, raising the hands of Frank and Gene Stanley right above us here, saying,